Why do I always wear my chaps? Because I get a better ride. Very rarely do I personally get on a horse when I don't put on my chaps. And to me, I put those chaps on. Well, sure, they protect you and stuff like that, especially if you're gonna ride all day or it's cold weather or wet weather. Darn sure want those chaps. But the reason I wear them every day is, to me, this leather right here kind of sticks to the leather on the saddle, whereas these cotton jeans just kind of, I feel like I'm sliding and moving around. Boy, I kind of get a nice stick and a good ride and a good feel when I got those chaps on. So that's why I wear them. Besides that, there's different types of chaps as well. So this here, a leggings, and you can call them leggings or chaps, C-H-A-P-S, but it's called a shotgun style or shotgun leggings. And you can see they fit pretty tight to your legs right here. Reason I like this style is because, you know, working horses and doing clinics, I'm on the ground quite a bit. And so I don't want like an old bat wing type shaft where I'm, you know, hitting myself and it's harder to get around. So I like the shotguns. And the shotguns right here, you can see they zip all the way down. So if you get a custom made pair, they're gonna take a measurement of your leg. And so, man, this thing's gonna really fit nice. Always, when you get a good shap maker right here, they're gonna feel a little tight when you come because this leather is actually a skin of a cow. And so it's gonna stretch a little bit. So by the time you get it done, they're gonna fit just right. Now, some people say, boy, you got your shafts really long, but I like them long a little bit because when I sit in the saddle, I'm gonna have a bend in my leg and they're gonna ride up a little bit. So a little bit long, but not too long. I don't wanna be tripping on them. A lot of people will ask me about these fringes right here. You know, the fringe can be functional, believe it or not. It's like the fetlock hairs or feathers on a horse's leg. That water will run down here. Many a time I've broken a piece of leather or like a water loop on a bridle and I didn't have anything to fix it. I just cut that off right there and patched it right up with a piece of the fringe. If you went down here, you can find a couple of these places where they're missing where I've actually cut it off and done that. A shap should have a small belt. You know, there's different ways to fit. Some guys like to tie them on back here like this or buckle them on the back like this. These buckle in the front, but you can see how the belt is wide in the back and it's real small in the front. There's a reason for that. A good pair of shafts has always got a small piece on it, so that way if you got hung up on those shafts or something, or this went over the saddle horn, it's intended, it's made where it will break. So I think that's really important right there. So different types of shafts for different folks. There's all different types of shafts. This is what they call a chink. And a lot of this came from a lot of the buckaroo styles. And what they do, to me, a good pair of chinks stops about right there. Sometimes my fringe will hang all the way down to here, but it stops right around here. So when I get on a horse, I'm still protected all the way around here. But because they're a little bit shorter for my groundwork, if I'm branding or working a horse, I can really get around easier. You see a lot of guys, sometimes I'll wear these chinks in the summertime when it's really hot. So again, good leather. This is an old, these are old tan leathers so that you can get them wet. A lot of times they'll get wet while riding a rainstorm. You don't want to do that like with an elk hide. That's what you don't want to do it with. So why do I wear the shaps? Gives me a better ride. And don't forget, they also look pretty cool.